a sacrifice of thanksgiving. He who offers a sacrifice of thanksgiving honors me. Psalm 50:23. One of the most meaningful things we will ever do as a believer is to offer up to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving. What exactly does that mean? First of all, we see that it is an offering. We know that much of the Old Testament is filled with the ceremonies of sacrifices and offerings. Moses did not design these ceremonies. God did. Therefore, each and every one of them was sacred in that they were designed to honor God. He who offers a sacrifice of thanksgiving honors God. Perhaps our giving of thanks will mean much more to God if it means much more to us. Rather than throwing it out as one of our duties, we should pause and consider the goodness of God and praise Him for all He has done. We should make much of the God who has done much for us. Secondly, we see that it is a sacrifice. Though all the sacrifices of the Old Testament did not involve the slaying of an animal, all sacrifices required the offering up of something to the Lord. David said, "I will not present burnt offerings to the Lord my God that have cost me nothing." There are times when we can give thanks without any real cost to us. However, some of the deepest and most meaningful times of thanksgiving come with a price tag. It is one thing to thank God during a time of blessing, but something else to thank Him during the time of burden. By faith, these people overthrew kingdoms, ruled with justice, and received what God had promised them. They shut the mouths of lions, quenched the flames of fire, and escaped death by the edge of the sword. Their weakness was turned to strength. They became strong in battle and put whole armies to flight. Women received their loved ones back again from death, but others were tortured, refusing to turn from God in order to be set free. They placed their hope in a better life after the resurrection. Some were jeered at, and their backs were cut open with whips. Others were chained in prisons. Some died by stoning. Some were sawed in half, and others were killed with the sword. Some went about wearing skins of sheep and goats, destitute and oppressed and mistreated. They were too good for this world, wandering over deserts and mountains, hiding in caves and holes in the ground. All these people earned a good reputation because of their faith, yet none of them received all that God had promised. Lastly, we see that it is thanksgiving. The psalmist did not say, "He who offers a sacrifice begrudgingly honors God." Instead, he said, "He who offers a sacrifice of thanksgiving honors God." Consider the example of Hannah as she prayed in the temple. "I asked the Lord to give me this boy, and He has granted my request. Now I am giving him to the Lord, and he will belong to the Lord his whole life." And they worshiped the Lord there. It would have been easy for Hannah to place the emphasis on her willingness to make an offering and the sacrifice she was making. But if she had, it would not have honored the Lord. Instead, Hannah placed the emphasis on the graciousness of God to give her a son. The result of her attitude was that she was able to give him back in gratitude. I'm sure that Psalm 50:23 means a lot of different things to a lot of different people. Even as I have been writing it, I have been wrestling in mind over something that I desire but am not able to have. The psalmist's words have made me realize that rather than pouting over what I don't have, I should be grateful for what I do have. In addition, it has helped me to realize that this disappointment is an opportunity for me to offer up to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving. Lord, I offer up to You my desires in the spirit of thanksgiving, knowing that You have been good to me and very, very merciful. Amen.